To truly be a great leader, it is said that a person must be connected to others and committed to purpose. This past year, Steve Romerheim embodied those traits while working passionately to represent the U.S. pork industry and their interests around the world as president of the National Pork Board. Steve Romerheim projected a positive image of the pork industry while working to advance key initiatives this past year.
I think about his passion and dedication to the industry, and that's how I really got to know Steve, was through National Pork Board activities. He was on the board a term ahead of me, got involved. He encouraged me to run for an officer position, and he's just been a good leader. So when I think of Steve, I think of high energy. He's a wonderful guy. He's got family values. He's deep rooted in agriculture and the swine industry. He understands our industry. He understands the needs. And he's really dedicated. So that is one thing. When you have passion and dedication, that's a recipe for success that can be contagious for future leaders.
The value that Steve brings to the U.S. pork industry is really one of credibility. You know, he and his wife Charlotte are really a team. They love to open up their farm to visitors. They've hosted all types of tours, and the pride really shows when you bring somebody in that's curious about where their food comes from and how it's raised. Steve and his wife, Charlotte, really enjoy doing that. And I think that credibility really comes across for the U.S. pork industry.
Steve and his wife, Char, along with their daughter and son-in-law, Leah and Josh Gradert, operate Highland Swine near Alcester, South Dakota, which finishes 12,000 hogs annually. They are also part owners in SDI Pork, LLC, which finishes 120,000 hogs annually. Highland Farms also produces corn and soybeans on 1,600 acres.
My farming background begins a long time ago with my family, a small family farm, and myself and my twin sister, and we grew up doing chores. I had my first sows when I was 8 years old as a 4-H project, and I've been raising pigs ever since.
In addition to farming, Steve and Char enjoy spending time with both of their daughters and grandchildren. Leah and Josh have one son, and their daughter Laura Fondness lives near Laverne, Minnesota with her husband Matt and their son. As Steve began pork production, he recognized the need to contribute through service. And like many other pork board leaders, Steve's leadership grew, as did his commitment to the organization. He is past president of the South Dakota Pork Producers Association, serving on its board from 2001 to 2011. He also is past president of Agriculture United for South Dakota and currently serves on the South Dakota Animal Industry Board.
I can't emphasize enough the importance of folks getting involved to begin with, and secondly, that their involvement is going to mean something. And that's what's been my inspiration all these years of working, is that I'm doing something that means more than just my income at home.
All of us here today are glad Steve made the decision to take his leadership skills to the next level. The pork industry needs more people like Steve, people willing to serve through leadership and by example. The pork industry has benefited from Steve's leadership and his accomplishments.
So during Steve's term as president, probably three major things jump out at me. First is WeCare. We've had 10 years of success there, and his ability to move that forward to the next generation is really important. In addition to that, Steve has really embraced our emerging technology focus, designed to make sure that the pork board and the pork industry in general really well positioned to take advantage of new advances in innovation and technology. And third is really our new strategic planning effort. These things only come around about once every 5 years, and Steve's leadership there has been instrumental.
Of course, the WeCare and PQA messaging that we work with on a daily basis. So reigniting that base and making sure that all of our consumer groups and other constituents that we work with on a daily basis understand that those founding principles are the things that we stand behind every day in order to create the safest, best supply of pork in the world.
The accomplishments of this board, to me, the biggest one is the redefining of pork board, if you will, with our new strategic plan. A lot of time and effort and energy has been spent on this, and a lot of great people have been involved. And while the results of this planning aren't yet known, it's going to reshape pork board. It's not going to be Grandpa's pork board anymore. Our CEO, Bill Even, one of his famous statements is that we have to keep up with the speed of business. So we're trying to reform everything from operations to budgeting to everything that we do using a model that is based differently than what we've done before. So that while change is hard, it's slow to get accepted, this is really, really, in my opinion, going to be a very, very good change for not only pork board, but our whole industry.
The success of these initiatives will benefit all pork producers. And Steve reminds us it's the vision and work of the board and stakeholders to make changes to improve the industry.
We've collected money, people, expertise, and effort into one spot that's all working for the same goal, and that's to serve the pork industry.
Steve reminds all producers that the industry needs and values their input and involvement to keep things moving forward.
If you hear any message in the next week or two, this is the important one, is reach out, get involved. It's great. This is an awesome time.
Steve has led by example and is proud to have worked with other great leaders. And Steve, we would like to thank you. Thank you for tirelessly sharing yourself, your farm, and your passion with the world. Thank you for countless hours of meetings, travel, and planning. Thank you for sharing with us your vision for the future and for leading the Pork Board to embrace and achieve that future so that we all continue to enjoy success.